They were asked to vacate the encroached area repeatedly, but they resorted to buy time till the situation reached a saturation point. The authorities then sought the court's intervention and got evacuation orders. And today the process of evacuation took place under the supervision of police.
Well, scenes of this kind have become the order of the day in Namma city. Government agencies like BDA and BBMP are seen evacuating people from encroached sites at regular intervals. And today, it was the evacuation of dwellers of the Jai Bhuvaneshwari Nagar slum in Siddhapura. The slum board officials, with the help of two JCBs, demolished the illegal structures in the area. It was done under the supervision of police to avoid any untoward incident. The 512 slum dwellers of Bhuvaneshwari Nagar have been allotted alternative sites in Kudlu near Parapana Agrahara. Several of them have already vacated the place and occupied the houses allotted to them. Some of them had decided to stay back for reasons only known to them. But the officials of the slum board convinced them and made arrangements to transport their belongings to Kudlu. But there was another group which had not been allotted houses in Kudlu. They were staging a protest and urging the officials to relocate them before dismantling their structures.
ನೂರು ಜನ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ವಾಸವಾಗಿರೋರು ಈ ಸದ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಇವ್ರಿಗೆ ಇವ್ರ ಹತ್ರ ಐ ಡಿ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಇದೆ ರ್ಯಾಷನ್ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಇದೆ ಇವರು ಕೋರ್ಟ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗಿ ವಾಪಸ್ ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಯಾರು ನಾಲ್ಕು ಜನ ಸೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಎರಡು ದಿವಸ ಸ್ಟೇ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದೆ ಇವರೆಲ್ಲ ಅದು ನಾಲ್ಕು ಜನ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಸ್ಟೇ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದೆ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ನಂಬ್ಕೊಂಡು ಕೂತಿದ್ರು ನಿನ್ನೆ ಸಂಜೆ ನಾವು ಸ್ಲಮ್ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಕಮಿಷನರ್ ಹತ್ರ ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ನಾಳೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ ಶೋಮಾರನೇ ಏನಾದರೂ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಸೊ ಇವಾಗ ನೋಡಿದರೆ ಇವತ್ತೇ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೊಡಿತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ರಸ್ತೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ನಂಬಿಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಕಾಯ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಇನ್ನೂ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಮ ಲಾಯರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ವಾಲ್ರಾಜ್ ಹತ್ರ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ
ವೆಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಲಮ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ 5 acres ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ನಿಮ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ Though a lower court had issued an order for the evacuation, the slum dwellers challenged this order in an upper court. The legal battle was happening all these years, but 2 days ago, this court too issued an order directing the dwellers to vacate the place with immediate effect. It is precisely for this that the slum board officials had come here today to convince the residents and send them to Kudlu. On the other hand, a survey was conducted in 2001 to list the dwellers living in Bhuvaneshwari slum. Accordingly, 512 were identified as authorized dwellers and alternative sites were provided to them in Kudlu. But now, about 100 unauthorized dwellers are demanding sites for them. They had alleged that 2 to 3 sites have been allotted to one family in Kudlu. The slum board officials promised them to resolve the issue.
512 families we already alerted in Kudlu. They already are voluntarily they have shifted and got occupied his own house. Actually, some applications we submitted as per the court directions. As per norms of the board, we verified and give them suitable endorsement.
Well, the issue pertaining to Jai Bhuvaneshwari slum dwellers seems to have been resolved for now. There are some residents who have neither houses here nor sites in Kudlu, but the slum board is confident about finding shelters for them. Maltesh for News 9, Bengaluru.
You must have heard of BBMP installing CCTV cameras at the famous Bugle Rock Park in Baswangudi. While a lot of young couples throng the park, it also allegedly plays host to several youngsters who do drugs and rob the senior citizens who come for a walk. Palike's decision to install cameras attracted a lot of criticism because BBMP was accused of keeping a track of canoodling couples in the heritage landmark. But they have now clarified, stating that the cameras are for public safety and not to spy on couples.
We are going to install the CC camera in our Bugle Rock Park, Kalaibande Udyanavana. This safety for the senior citizen, also the chain snatching, avoid the chain snatching in the park and main roads. There is a tourist part of the Basungudi. Basungudi, this is the tourist part of Bangalore, sightseeing spot. Just Bull Temple, and then big Ganesha Temple. There are surrounding Gavi Gangadeshwara Temple. That's why we are going to put the CC camera in our park. This is the trial basis we are going to put that CC camera. it is successful means we are going to install in other park also.
Namma Metro's track laying work is on in full swing. We visited Ground Zero to catch up with all the construction activities. Take a look.
Work is on at a brisk pace. Tracks are being welded together and the coupled tracks are being carried into the tunnel. These works are indeed unique. We will tell you why. The tracks you see here are imported from Austria. These tracks have extraordinary endurance and strength. According to BMRCL officials, these are 10 times more powerful than the ones used by Indian Railways. BMRCL is using these tracks only in tunnels where chances of accidents are higher compared to open tracks. Even the welding machine is unique. This too has been imported from the US. It takes just 3 minutes for the machine to weld the tracks. There is a timer installed on the machine that keeps track of the number of tracks welded. Only the welded tracks are cooled. They are then taken inside the tunnel.
ಇದು ನಮ್ದೊಂದು 18 ಮೀಟರ್ಸ್ ಗೆ ಒಂದು ರೈಲ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಈ ರೈಲ್ ಇಂದ ಒಂದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ರೇಲ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಫ್ಲ್ಯಾಶ್ ಬಟ್ ವೆಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತೇವೆ ಇದು ಒಂದು ಜಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ಕೆ 3 ನಿಮಿಷ ಟೈಮ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತೆ ಒಂದು ದಿನಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು 30 ವೆಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಅವರೇಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೆ ನಾವು 3 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ ರೈಲ್ ಲಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ವೆಲ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ ಇದನ್ನ ವೆಲ್ಡಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಎಂಜಿ ರೋಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ವೆಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮೆಜೆಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಅವರಿಗೆ ವೆಲ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಪುಲ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನಾವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಗೆ
ಸೋ ಫಾರ್ 593 meters of tracks have been laid and it is said to be the longest track in Namma Metro. The officials say that carrying the tracks inside has not been an issue for them. But since no network is accessible inside the tunnel, the workers rely on sound communication to pass and take instructions. This machine will be used to construct a 19 kilometer track.
This is a machine got from America. Don't name that thing, but it has been approved by RDSO. Which is a research development and scientific organization has cleared this machine and it's a very sophisticated machine and it welds it takes only hardly 3 minutes to weld and then it cools through air it's called it's quenching through air not by water or oil only by air it takes 1 minute so total within 4 minutes the whole 18 meter track is being completed this is the only vending machine and you would have seen the tractor also only with the help of the tractors one or two tractors they are pulling this after welding yeah it is being pulled
it's an 18.5 km stretch between Bayyappanahalli and Mysore road and 4.8 km of it is underground the work of coupling the tracks will happen at Cubbon Park station the work is expected to be completed in the next 4 months Pavitra for News 9 Bengaluru.
Well, you must have been to a dog show, but have you ever been to a pet fashion show? Bangalore Pet Fashion Week saw pets in Namma City wear designer wear and walk the ramp in style. Here's a report.
The Bangalore Pet Fashion Week saw pets from Namma City get dressed in designer wear and walk the ramp in style. Most of the dogs which attended the event wore clothes designed by fashion designers and stole the limelight throughout the show. The organizer of the event said that the event was conducted to get the dogs out of their homes and indulge in something different.
We've completed 5 editions of P Factor and the Fashion Week is the highlight. We're going to do it once in 6 months and the basic aim of doing the Fashion Week is to show people that dogs also have a life and they need equal equality when it comes to people as well. They can also show off and walk the ramp with the models. So I want people to realize that okay, dogs also have a life. They do have a taste. So you can take your dog anywhere you go. I want people to make it as a practice that you know don't just keep the dog at home just because you know you need somebody at home to guard the house or to play with your children. Take the dogs out, let them socialize with a lot of other pets. You know that's when a lot of issues are also solved. Dogs will not be aggressive. A lot of dog issues are also solved. So this also aims at educating people on how to take better care of dogs.
The clothes designed for the dogs were made by fashion designers who exclusively design for pets. They say that the trend is catching up at a fast pace.
Bengaluru, really now it's catching up like a trend. Because, you know, it's actually a trend in US or UK. You know, there's this designer who makes like a bomb, like millions. His design sells for millions. So because now too many people are going towards pets and, you know, a lot of people are adopting, you know, dogs or cats or whatever. So each one is throwing parties for dog's birthday. Dogs are getting married or dogs are having, you know, puppies and all the things. So, you know, we are doing, you know, theme-based costumes or clothes for the pets. So that's where the demand already started.
The Pet Fashion Week also saw dog trainers demonstrate the power of security dogs and how they can become your personal bodyguards. People were amazed with the training methodology and attacking skills. This event also saw many pet stylists and groomers showing their skills. They discussed the various services they offer to pets.
We have a blueberry facial, we use South Bark facial, and we have oatmeal bath. What we do is we use an oatmeal shampoo and we use natural oats so that it hydrates the skin of the dog, and it's really good for dogs. I'll recommend all the dogs to get oatmeal bath. It's really good for their skin and their fur hair. It really hydrates. And we have body cure, and we body cure the dogs. We have paw cream. We apply the paw creams on the paws so that the skin becomes smooth under the paw. So there are a lot of stuff we do for the dog, just like the way we do it for humans.
In all, it was an amazing day out for pets and their owners, who showed off their fashion sense and proved that even pets can walk in style. Vivek Vinayak for News 9, Bengaluru.
And well, it was quite a memorable day for everyone associated with Bishop Cotton's Girls and Boys High School. The institution completed 150 years of existence, and the celebrations that were witnessed inside the school premises was anything but ordinary. With Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam as the guest of honor and Usha Udip live in concert to entertain the audiences, the event saw over 3,000 people that included alumni and others associated with the schools in attendance and cheering.
Well, I'm greeting 150th year, very big period. Okay. I'm sure it has got all the prosperity and peace. Unique leaders will come in science, technology, history, everywhere. Where Bishop Cotton Boys School will provide the leadership. Boys School, 150 years.
Even girls.
Best wishes for them.
Thank you.